Start.
He's getting it ready. I hope so.
Basically, it's feeds. It just changes what the screen is seeing every time. So it helps out.
Good morning. My name is Donna Nye, and I am the media specialist here at Wood Station Elementary School. Our principal, Mr. Ernie Ellis, sends his regrets that he's unable to attend today, but in his absence, he's allowing me to do the honors. So it is my pleasure to welcome each and every one of you here today for the grand opening celebration of Carson Street Station, another Ben Carson Reading Room. We began this journey back in October of 2019, thinking that we would be opening in April, having our opening celebration, but then schools were closed in March. Here we are almost 1 year later, and we cannot be any more excited than we are today to be introducing Carson Street Station to our community. We are privileged to have in our presence today some very distinguished guests. Dr. Ben Carson's wife, Mrs. Candy Carson, members representing the Holland Family Foundation, several members with Catoosa County Schools, the school district, including our own superintendent, Mrs. Nina Reed, the extremely talented mural artist, Mrs. Gail Hinton from Knoxville, Tennessee, Mr. Jason Neal, along with other representatives from Brown Industries Incorporated, who helped design and ultimately built the train cars in Carson Street Station, representatives from the Chamber of Commerce, and several other individuals that played important parts of this project are here as well. Since the Ben Carson Reading Room requires an allocated space, our walls received fresh paint, our floors were recarpeted, and our shelving was made mobile. In other words, our library received a complete renovation. So it is with heartfelt thanks that we express our appreciation to both the Holland Family Foundation and Mrs. Dina Reeves and Catoosa County Schools for supporting us in this project. Our vision was to provide a space where children can select a book and choose a nook as they read, explore, dream, imagine, and think big. It is my personal hope that as children enjoy the space, that they'll always remember those super cool train cars at Wood Station Elementary in the library, and those words that come from the little engine that could, "I think I can. I think I can, as they explore and pursue each of their academic endeavors. We are the generals. We consider ourselves family here at Wood Station Elementary, and we are so thankful to be adding Carson Street Station in our home. So again, welcome, and thank you for choosing to be a part of our celebration today. And now, singing Wood Station home, here are the Wood Station Singers.
Thank you.
On behalf of Catoosa County Public Schools and Wood Station Elementary, I would like to thank Dr. and Mrs. Carson for the outstanding project that they provided for us in establishing the Ben Carson Reading Project. I know your commitment to children's literacy will help this school achieve our vision to prepare every child to reach their full potential so they graduate prepared to be good citizens and leaders of the future. So thank you all. Good morning. I'm Becky Autry, Becky Holland Autry with the Holland Family Foundation. I'm used to talking to children, not adults, but even adults like stories. So I'm sharing with you today a very short story about my dad. He was the fifth of 10 children growing up in the Depression and World War I. You've all had American history. You know what that means. He looked around him and said, "What can I do that will be different so I can provide for my family?" He decided then he needed an education. He needed to learn. He needed to think. He needed to do everything that was asked of him and just a little bit more. And that was his philosophy all through life, helping up other people, and you'll wind up getting your dreams too. So he continued to pursue that. He was indeed successful. And when he reached the point that he had provided us, he started the Holland Family Foundation so that he could help others who were willing to work hard. For over 20 years, the foundation was able to get scholarships to students in Catoosa County to help toward college expenses so that they could continue to achieve their dreams. It wasn't based on financial need. It was based on student work ethic, student character, and student service in the community. Then he learned about the Carson Reading Room, and he said, "This is a perfect fit for the Holland Family Foundation. We are a family of readers. We love reading." When the oldest two grandchildren reached elementary school one summer, he said, "You know what, let's have a contest. The two of you read as many books as you want to. Your mom has to approve, and it has to be fun. Then at the end of summer, we'll see who read the most, the two of you or me." So it got down to the last night. He offered them a prize. "You have to bring a prize to the award ceremony, because I might win. So you bring me a prize, and I'll bring you a prize." It's the day of the big reveal. The youngest one said, "Hey, Becky, do you think we'll win?" And I said, "I don't know. Granddad is an awfully good reader. How many books have you read?" 224. "Well, I said, well, I have to see tonight. Could you read a few more?" I said, "Sure, we'll read a few more." Obviously, the girls won. Dad changed that as we had more grandchildren in the family, and he said, "You know what, I'm not going to put limits on you. I will pay you 5 cents a page to read. None of you are old enough to have part-time jobs yet, so here's a part-time job. You earn as much as you want to. The rules stay the same. Mom has to approve the book. It has to be fun." This is like paying somebody to eat brownies. You get paid to read. So I was reading to my son. He was still too young to read to himself, but he got to participate. We finished the book. We went to the library a couple of times a week because you can only get 35 at a time. He liked books. Not going to say he didn't play by the rhythm, but he liked books. His mama did too, and you can sit still when you read books. We finished one, and we were getting near the end. His face got lower and lower, his shoulders started sleeping, and finally, when it was over, he said, "Oh man, I can't count this one for granddaddy. It was dumb." I said, "We read it in good faith, but it's going to be good with counting it." I am thankful that the media center specialist here has taken such care to choose books, so none of these students are going to walk away going, "That book was dumb." They have great books. If you have not been in there yet, it is amazing. So hats off to all of you who worked so hard to make it so beautiful. As much fun as I think reading is, some of these children haven't fallen in love with reading yet. I read a quote just earlier today. I can't quote it yet, but a paraphrase. Everybody has a favorite book. Some people just haven't found it yet. This
reading list, has books of every genre, excellent authors, they have classics, they have new things, they have any subject that could interest these children, and they put it in this exciting environment that's going to draw these kids in. I am so grateful to have the privilege to partner with the Carsons to help to provide this. But thank you most of all to you educators, because you're the ones inspiring these kids every day. So thank you to you. Come on, look at the colors here. Grandma, you look at this school, yeah. And you notice I didn't take off my mask because it's all about thinking big. In this kind of cancel culture of what's going on in our nation as of right now, we need to find ways to help our children, and well, help everyone deal with the situation we're facing. It's just exciting to know that here, the meeting for school, that the kids get an opportunity to learn, because in so many places, when kids are in areas where they don't have their own computer at home, and so on, they're really at a disadvantage. So thank you, Georgia, for doing this. It's exciting, and whenever we have a reading room, I always say, I want to be there. If the kids need you, you need to be back. We don't have kids here right now, but for those of you who are watching, we want you to know we're behind you. We care about you, and when we put in a reading room, this is about you. You know, when you go in there, you can pick any book you want. It's not required to be this one or that one. You don't have to write a book report. If you want to, we'll take it. Because we love to hear your thoughts on these things. But to have the freedom to choose what you want to read and go wherever you want to go, take those adventures in the book. Because each book is its own adventure. I tell you, there is an advantage, or let me put it this way, there's some perks being married to a neurosurgeon. When my husband was on the speaker circuit, he would talk about the power of the brain, and this is something a lot of people don't hear. There's something should be in our curriculum. I think they should just go and put it in there, because it's good for us each to know, whether you're an adult or a child, at whatever level you are, that your brain can process 2 million bits of information every second. 2 million bits of information every second. Now, let's say that down, because think about it. Even when you take time to raise your hand to answer a question, and in some of my talks, I'm going to talk about this, and he was talking about the neural pathways, you know, like the sound waves have to enter your external auditory medium, the tension upon your tympanic membrane, so the vibratory force where the mechanical energy is changed to. Changing to electrical energy and that's going. Okay, so it would take him out of time, 45 seconds, to say what it took a second to do. We are miracles and wonders we made. So, considering that each person with a normal brain can do just about anything, so think about doing this every second. And sometimes kids will be told, don't learn this or don't learn that, because you overload your brain. You can't overload your brain. So, if you were to learn one fact every second, or think about it, it's hard to even conceptualize a fact in one second. Rather, it's going to take 2. But if you were able to just consider that you could learn one fact every second, it would take you 3 million years to start to scale the capacity of your brain. So you can't overload your brain. So fill it with good stuff. I mean, we've got these rooms there, and we have libraries too. For those of you who don't have a reading room yet, you know, just contact the office, see what you can do. We can get one there, because we really want to put one in as many schools as we can, because it makes a difference. When kids can choose what they want to read, and they develop themselves to be the best they can be. Because a lot of times we say, oh, I can just put things up on my iPad or my cell phone and so on and so forth, but those aren't the ones that solve the problem. Think about it. If you've got this knowledge here, this knowledge there, this knowledge there, and then they convert it into your brain and come up with a new idea, you're going to make a better mousetrap. and you're going to be the one that's successful. So you put in as much as you can, because you got the space there. We're carefully and honestly made for eternity, so keep that in mind. Now, some of you might say, I've got some subjects, though, that I'm just not good at. Like, I'm not good at math. I'm not good at chemistry. I'm not good at reading. So let's say with reading. They're all based on building blocks. You think of physics, even. It doesn't matter what it is. Space for people. Are we there? Okay, sorry about that. Let's say that you, for reading, you couldn't read, it just seemed hard, and let's say you knew all the letters except A, S, B, and E. It would be difficult. But you plug those building blocks in there. Yeah. So, you know, all of the subjects are like that, and if you get to one where, you feel like you just don't understand it, it's too hard, go back to where it made sense for you and read from there. Or you can come to anybody in this room, and that includes the schools, you know, and your family. We will help you. And if we don't know the answer, we'll direct you to the right place or take you there. Okay? So keep that in mind, that there are those who care enough about you to make sure that you develop yourself in the best that you can be. So we talked about building blocks, and I'm trying to think of the better read my notes, I'm sorry. The main thing to remember is the person that has the most to do with what happens to you. In your classroom, you don't understand something. There's 20 or 30 of you and only one teacher. It's okay to go and ask. Don't feel like it's dumb to ask. No, it's smart to ask, it's dumb not to ask. Because again, that person that's in charge might not realize that you're not getting this particular aspect, and they can help you find it. So we are so excited to be here partnering with the Holly family. Thank you again for all that you've been doing. Thank you, Dad, for his vision. It has just been wonderful. This is the fifth room that you've put in Catoosa County, and it's just exciting. They're all beautiful. Each one, like people ask me, which one is your favorite room? And it's like your children. they're all wonderful, and they're all decorated wonderfully. They pull the kids in, and it's making a difference. I tell you, and it's just there's a couple more things. One is that when we were in California at once, and it was beautifully decorated again. And then during the after the program session, we were in the room, and one little kid comes up and says, "And I was here." Some of these kids are still in cars, or they're in, under bridges or whatever, and to have a place where they can go and feel safe, and where they can explore and develop themselves, it is a big deal. I mean, we don't know people's situations and how they got there, but if we can do something to make their life a little better and to help them to realize. Because each one of these kids has so much potential. Let's let them realize this is the first incarnation. Thank you so much.
Greetings, boys and girls, faculty members, and special guests. My name is Dr. Ben Carson. While I no longer practice medicine, for more than 30 years, I had the privilege of working as a neurosurgeon at Johns Hopkins Hospital in Baltimore, Maryland. Neurosurgeons are people who operate on the brain and the spinal cord. It's very delicate and complex work, and pediatric neurosurgeons obviously deal with children. from birth, and sometimes even before birth, I've operated on children that were still in the mother's womb, right up until adulthood, deal with tumors and vascular malformations and trauma and congenital anomalies and a whole series of extraordinarily complex things. But the reward is that you give people not only life, but quality life. And that's what it's all about. In addition to my work in the hospital, my wife Candy and I are the co-founders of the Carson Scholars Fund. We recognize the importance of a good education and have dedicated ourselves to encouraging young people to excel academically, expand their horizons through reading, and to develop their talents to help their fellow man. Today is a special day, and I am honored to share it with you. We are gathered to open your school's Ben Carson Reading Room. The Reading Room is a special place filled with hundreds of books. Magical things happen when you open a book. With a book and your imagination, you can travel the world without leaving the reading room. You can travel through space, roam the earth with the dinosaurs, or fly like a bird. You can spend time with old friends like Jimmy Moody, Pete the Cat, or Big Nate. You can meet new friends like Elephant and Piggy, Pickalicious, the Pigeon, the Wimpy Kid. You'll find books about cats, dogs, elephants, spiders, monkeys, and numerous other animals. Anywhere you want to go, anyone you want to meet, you can do it in the reading room by picking out the good book. This room was built for you to explore history and the world through books. Harriet Tubman once said, "Every great dream begins with a dreamer." The reading room is designed to fuel your dreams and to inspire your imagination. When I was your age, I wasn't a good student and was frequently teased by my classmates about my grades and poor performance in school. I didn't like reading. I didn't like studying. I thought I was stupid. All I wanted to do was go outside and play with my friends. But, you know, my mother was very disturbed by the fact that I was not achieving in school. And she didn't know what to do. She prayed for wisdom and came up with this idea of turning off the TV, allowing us to watch only two or three TV programs during the week. And with all that spare time, we had to read two books apiece from the Detroit Public Libraries every week and submit to her written book reports, which you can read, but we didn't know that. But I'll tell you, she didn't dictate what we had to do. And as I started reading about people of great accomplishment, I began to recognize something. I began to realize that the person who has the most to do with what happens to you in life is you. That you don't have to be a victim of circumstance. You don't have to be manipulated by other people. That was vastly liberating to me. And I got to the point where I couldn't wait to get home to read my books. My mother would say, "Benjamin, put the book down and eat your food." That was always reading. And within the space of a year and a half, I went from the bottom of the class to the top of the class, much to the consternation of all those students who used to laugh and call me dummy. Through reading, I gained knowledge, confidence, and the desire to be successful in school and in life. A lot of people in your school and community worked hard to create this room. These people donated their time, talents, and resources because they know the importance of reading and are committed to your success. Congratulations on your new Ben Carson Reading Room. I challenge each and every one of you to do your very best, and I encourage you to read every day and to always think big.
There are over 230 Ben Carson Reading Rooms across the nation located in schools just like yours. We would like to express our most heartfelt gratitude to the Holland Family Foundation for sponsoring this reading room. This is the fifth Ben Carson Reading Room to be sponsored by the Holland Family. The Holland Family's commitment to the community is helping empower young people to make their dreams a reality. We would also like to thank the Ben Carson Reading Room committee members for bringing the reading room to fruition. Congratulations, Wood Station Elementary School students, on your new Ben Carson Reading Room.
Good morning. My name is Harris Rich, and I will be reading a paragraph called The Reason for Reading. Reading is important to me, as it encourages me to think big, to speak big, and to imagine. As I open the book, I begin to read. I can visualize myself as the star character. When reading these pieces, I am always interested in the adventure series of Phil Crosby Tate, and in his story series, I am the trailblazer who refuses to be forgotten. Reading is important to me because it allows me to escape the worries of the pandemic and the other policies of this world. I'm reminded to dream big, hope big, and draw what I can do. I would like to thank the Common Family Foundation for sponsoring our live stream.
I thought I could.
But
you see, he believed that he did. all enjoy life with them.
In prison reading.